So what's behind the sliding doors?
Okay, so behind these doors is, as I mentioned, the climate-controlled area where all of the woodworking is done, where we make all the cabinets and the guitars. So let's check it out.
How are you?
This is the area where all of the cabinets for all Carbon Pro Sound speakers and guitar amplifiers and bass amplifiers are assembled. They're cut on CNC machines, but they're hand-assembled, hand-sanded, hand-filled, so that everything is perfect before we cover them in the various Colex carpet or spray-on coating that protects the cabinet.
Awesome.
From this point on, it's basically all guitar production, and if you pan over here to the shelf here, you'll see some of the raw wood materials that we have. Some beautiful pieces of wood, hard to see until you actually stain them or get color going on them, but quilt, flame maple, mahogany, all the woods are stocked here. Here's some raw stock that we've pre-assembled for five-piece necks, and these will probably become a guitar neck. And again, some more stock wood, koa, and so forth.
How many guitars can you get out of this piece right here?
Depends on the model of the guitar. You know, if somebody wants a guitar made from a solid piece of koa, then obviously we would use the whole piece. If it's going to be a veneer where they order just a koa top, then it's different. We could probably get maybe two instruments with a koa top on that. Here's some samples of various wood. Flame maple. This obviously is a just a small strip of it, just to get an idea of what the wood looks like before any finish goes over it. The piece underneath it, this is spalted maple, and this is a very, very difficult piece of wood to work with. It's a very nice sample of spalted maple, and spalted maple is harvested from dead trees, so a lot of the figuring that you see in there is actually the rot that has set in the tree itself. So it's nice that we're actually able to make use of a tree that has died, but the wood itself is very brittle, and it's very, very hard to work with. So we have to do quite a bit of extra work in sealing this wood in order to be able to even sand it when it comes to doing the final work on it. But the results are just spectacular, and so we feel it's worth our time and efforts to work with this type of wood, even though it can be very difficult at times.
Awesome. Now, these ebony fingerboards?
This is a stock of ebony fingerboards, correct.
Nice.
This is a belt sander, and normally pieces of wood that would normally, like this piece of quilt here, that would normally go on the top of the guitar. Pieces get hook matched together, and that's another process of grinding and sanding the wood down so that you actually have a really nice matching hook match piece from the same piece of wood. And to get the thickness proper, they'll feed this into the belt sander here. They'll adjust the height of it and sand down the top before they actually adhere to the guitar.
Right.
So we'll head over here to our left. So here's an example of an instrument that has its neck already shaped. It's a neck through body, so the body wings have been glued on. The quilt top has been glued on, and as you see, we have a template that actually gives them an outline to line up the body top with the actual body itself. And then we bend the top on many of our models, where we'll actually wet the wood to make it pliable for that arm cut, so that you're actually getting the top following the natural contour of that arm cut. So once this is arrived at a stage like this, it goes into our CNC machine. What we're seeing is a carb top guitar right now being routed out. And being that the carb top guitars are set in necks, we actually route the body and the neck separately before joining them together.
How is the guitar held to the bottom?
If you notice, there's no clamps or anything holding the body of this carb top guitar down. The entire bed, if you pan over to the left, you'll see these hoses connected to the platform. And there's a very powerful vacuum that is holding that guitar in place as the machine is routing.
Wow.
Off to the right here is the control panel where the operator will take and program the guitar for all of its necessary routing. If you look at a guitar like this, this looks like it's a V220 with a beautiful spalted maple top on it. Every guitar has a tag attached to it, or
is that
in this case,
who bought the guitar?
Exactly, or in this case, multiple tags to document everything that this guitar is supposed to have on it. So as you can see, this person ordered a spalted maple top and headstock on the guitar. They elected to get our signature abalone inlays, and these frets feel pretty big. This could be jumbo frets. They feel like they are jumbo frets. Let me double check the tag here. That'll tell me that is correct. They did order the option for stainless steel jumbo frets. So anything that you want on your guitar when you order it, all of that is present on the tag and allows all of our staff to double check the guitar as it goes through production and make sure that everything is right as it goes down the line. So as you can see again, in the body is glued onto the neck going through the body, and then they've glued the top on, and this will go into the machine next to be routed.
That looks awesome.
It's an amazing piece of wood.
I hate to ask a dumb question.
Sure.
What do you do with all the sawdust?
Well, that is actually not a dumb question. If you actually take a look, we have pipes going up overhead. We have a central vacuum system throughout the whole facility here that takes care of a huge portion of the dust that gets generated from the machine, and as well as the hand sanding. We have a central vacuum system that goes against the whole building. And so we do have people to come on and do the manual sweep up where they're cleaning the floors. But it's actually pretty minimal because we don't have a whole lot of stuff flying through the air. We have to keep as much down as far as all the dust in the air as possible for health reasons,
yep,
OSHA and all that stuff, but also to make a better product because we're not separating this part of the building from what you'll see off to the right over here, which is the buffing station. And the paint room is obviously a completely enclosed environment so you don't get dust contamination in the guitar. But again, we don't want dust flying through the air when they're buffing a guitar in this room as well. So this is another CNC that's set up for doing fingerboard. And as you can see, we'll do all of the inlays as well as the slotting for all the frets. Other companies may do it differently where they actually have a saw with number of circular blades that actually cuts all your slots. The way we do it on CNC is all computer controlled, so it's a lot more accurate when you're dealing with doing it that way than with a very thin blade that can actually wobble as it spins.
Nice.
So they dress all of the frets over here. Unfortunately, everybody wants lunch, but these are all the cars that are awaiting fret dressing. They've been painted, they've been clear coated, they're awaiting fret dressing, and they're awaiting their final buffing.